ULA's Vulcan rocket on its first national security mission, and Europe's Ariane 6 completing just its third mission ever. Let's get more from Bloomberg's Loren Grush, who leads our space coverage. I'm going to start with the ULA launch. Tell me about it. Why is it significant?
Well, this was the third launch for the Vulcan rocket, but as you mentioned earlier, it was their first national security mission, which is really what Vulcan was designed to do. ULA is one of an elite group of launch providers that can launch the Defense Department's most sensitive national security satellites. But this was their first time doing so with this particular rocket. They had to receive certification for it. So first they had to launch two missions with Vulcan to prove to the Space Force that it could handle launching national security satellites. And it actually suffered a tiny issue on its second flight. A strap-on booster had a small explosion. The rocket still made it to orbit, but it delayed the certification process. However, it did receive that certification in March and then ultimately was able to do this launch. And so that'll pave the way for even more national security missions moving forward.
And turning our attention to Europe and Ariane 6, how much is this just countries, entire areas of the globe trying to wean themselves less on dependency from SpaceX and have their own competitors?
Yeah, I think there was a lot of symmetry last night because these were the third flights of both of these rockets. And both of these vehicles are in a similar class to that of the SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket, which has essentially had a de facto monopoly on the launch market for the last few years, at least with this particular class of rockets. So the launches of these two vehicles kind of do symbolize, you know, perhaps there are going to be more options for other satellite providers in the future looking for this class of vehicle. Of course, it's going to take some time. As I said, these are the third flights. They've both struggled to ramp up in terms of their launch cadence, whereas the Falcon 9 is launching every few days. So it's going to take a while for them to reach up, but at least there are more and more rockets of this caliber coming online that satellite operators can turn to.